Hi, and welcome to Microsoft Build 2018. My name is Caitlin Bales, and I'm a software engineer on the Microsoft 365 programmability team. Today, I want to talk to you about our new Microsoft Graph SDK for Java, which allows you to get started writing rich server-side applications that utilize the power of Graph while minimizing the amount of boilerplate code you need to write. The Java SDK features strongly typed models for all the objects on the V1.0 endpoint. It uses a request builder pattern to build up URLs to naturally create your navigation paths through Graph. It also handles the boilerplate logic for sending and receiving requests so that you can work directly with the responses instead of writing HTTP connection logic yourself. Many objects in the SDK are set by default, such as the logger, HTTP provider, and the serializer, but each of these can be customized or swapped out to fit your specific needs. We also make it really easy to send custom headers and even custom requests from within the SDK if you need it. Finally, there are many extensibility points within the SDK. Some of these are generic helpers that make it easier to perform tasks across the SDK, and others perform very specific tasks for individual workloads. We also encourage developers to contribute their own helpers where they think they would provide value to the larger Graph developer community. Today, we're going to look at a demo that's going to show off these helper classes in more depth and see how it can make it easier to post content to Graph using the SDK. Multipart form post is a request type that allows us to pass multiple body parts into a request at one time. This is especially useful in OneNote, for example, where a page can have multiple types of content on it, such as text, HTML, images, and video. As you can see in the orange here, multipart makes use of boundaries to separate each content piece from the next. So let's look at how the Java SDK simplifies making this multipart request to OneNote. So now let's switch over to our demo. So we've got a blank OneNote notebook here, and we're going to be posting some content from SharePoint into it. So we've got a blank notebook, and we're going to find some content from within SharePoint and consolidate some links that we can kind of share out into it. Here we've got a simple Java console app. It's only got three files to it. So it's got a constant file. That's where we're going to post our client ID, our client secret, as well as a little HTML template that we can post our links into. We've also got an authenticator. So that's how we're going to get our access token that we can post into our OneNote. And then finally, our OneNote sync, which is going to do the bulk of our communication to Graph. So to get started, we're going to set up our authenticator, and we're going to have it fetch an access token for us. So in this case, we're using the client credential flow to get an access token for us. And then once we've gotten an access token and we're authenticated, we can go ahead and create that authentication provider. So that's the only thing that we need to do by default. We've got all the other pieces for us. So we've got a serializer, we've got a logger, we've got the HTTP provider, all that set for by default. The only other piece that we need is the authentication provider because we can't guess your access token. And then we can actually pass that in to the Graph service client, create from config, and now we've got a Graph client that we can start making calls to. So if we call Graph client, we can see that from here, we've got all of our root level objects available to us. So we can call users, and you can see we can start chaining up that request, and this is the request builder pattern that I was talking about. And we call build request, now we have our request that's completed. This is the point at which you can add custom headers, you can add query strings to that, and then when you're ready to send the request, you can call get, post, patch, all those verbs are available to you. Let's call get here. And now you've got a full request once we call get that's actually sending it across the wire to the service. And once we get that request back, it's actually going to deserialize us by default. In this case, we're getting a user collection back, and we can use that in our program as a user collection, as a deserialized object, just the same way that we'd use anything else in our program. So we're ready to go. But in this instance, let's go ahead and look at how we would work with this program for multipart use. So down here, we've got a little function that's posting content using multipart. And multipart here is our helper function in our Java SDK. So we're creating a new multipart object that's going to help us. And let's find some content that we can push to it. So here we've got our HTML body, where we've got a default that has some filler content, like a title and a body. And we just want to replace that filler content with a string that we built up previously in the sample that has some links in it from our OneDrive group from different SharePoint files that we've found. So we'll put all that HTML content into our HTML body. Just to show off some other ways that we can post data using Multipart, I've also grabbed some files from the file system. So I've loaded up an image file and a PDF file. Now let's attach those to the Multipart. So here you can see in the Multipart, we've added our HTML part. We need to give it a title, and we need to give it the contents of the HTML part itself. So adding an HTML part is pretty simple. Adding a file part, we need to specify what type that file part is. An HTML part, we always know what the type is, but in a file part, it's more ambiguous. So just the way you would do in a raw request, we need to specify what type that is. So this particular file is a JPEG, it could be a PNG. The great thing about OneNote is you can specify a lot of file types and it displays them all beautifully. So you can pretty much throw whatever you want at it. In this case, we're just doing an image and a PDF. We're giving it a name, and then we're giving it that file reference that we had before. Once we actually send that multipart, it's going to send up that file as a stream. And the last thing that we need to do now is, if you remember before, we had all those multipart boundaries in orange. The multipart helper will actually insert all those boundaries for us, but in the header of our request, we actually need to specify what that boundary is. That way, when we send the request, the service knows what to separate it with. So multipart has a property on it called header, and we can call to get that header back, and we can put that into the header of our request. So now that we've put that into our header option array, we can actually call the graph service. So we're going to get the OneNote of the group that we're interested in, and we'll get a specific section of our OneNote page that I showed you earlier. And then we're going to call the Pages API. So this will actually post a new page to that section. We're going to pass in the header option that we created earlier when we built the request. And finally, we're ready to post. So when we call multipart.content, it's going to build up that full stream request with all of the multipart boundaries embedded into it. And then we'll post all of that content to it. So let's run it and see what happens. The first thing we'll see is that we're seeing a lot of get methods. That's building up all of that data that we need to actually get the content that we want to write to the stream. So we're getting all those links and all that good stuff. Finally, we're going to see that it's posting that content. So here's the content that it's posted from our query. You see that it's given us a title that's from our default string. We've gotten all the links that we posted from OneDrive that we searched for. It's also posted our image part and our PDF part. So each of these are different parts of our same multipart request that we're able to do in one query using the multipart helper in the Java SDK. To get started with the SDK, head over to graph.microsoft.com and click on Samples and SDKs. All of our libraries are open source and available on GitHub, where you can read our wiki, open issues, and submit pull requests. If you have any questions on how to build your app on top of Graph, you can post a question on Stack Overflow with the tag Microsoft Graph. We have developers from all over the Graph product teams monitoring this tag. They're fast to respond, and from my experience, they're super helpful. Thank you so much for watching, and I can't wait to see what you build with Microsoft Graph.